Welcome back to the Fuller Fanatic channel. Today, I'm going to share a build I've been in pursuit of owning for more than a year. This is the Archbishop 2.0, designed by the Ferrum Forge Brothers and produced by We Knives. The initial release, which I believe was the only production run, took place in 2019. Coming in with a handle length of 4 3/8 of an inch, the Archbishop scales are very chunky in a good way. Similar to the Chavez 229 in scale thickness, this build masks these dimensions by chamfering the entire edge with a wide 45 degree angle, bringing the handle thickness to 50/100 of an inch. Finished in that signature Ferrum Forge Anno and Tumble, in my opinion, the Bishop's finish is levels above something like a Hinderer working finish due to its level of depth and saturated coloring. Ferrum Forge released a vast amount of variants, this being the Thruworks tie model. If you look at the mill pattern within the handle and you keep up with the Ferrum Forge designs, you will notice this is the exact pattern of the pillars milled into the opening area on the Ferrum Forge mallet, sporting high polished hardware and pivot screws which accent the blue build. The reversible 3D milled clip comes set in right hand orientation. The clip works great and the build stays secure in pocket. Looking at the handle spine side, again another signature touch is the solid titanium 3D gear style backspacer. From the side view, the spacer doesn't protrude beyond the frame's edge, but due to its depth, the spacer's amount of traction is ridiculous. Not sharp by any means, but when you press down, it feels sticky in a sense. Enclosing about half the spine side of the handles and continuing to wrap around the entire backside, then stopping at the tip of the blade. Equipped with two means of deploy, the Archbishop's flipper tab is very compact for the build and blade size. And dressed in the same jimping pattern, just reduced in overall size, in the same manner as the spacer, the tab is sticky in a good way. And due to its design and placement, slipping off the tab or failure to deploy from lack of grip isn't even a thought. As for the build's second means of deployment, the elongated opening hole is another touch often implicated into many of the Ferrum Forge builds. Honestly, for me, to be a true knife works production, the hole needs to be on the build. Its placement on the blade is perfect. Coupled with the 45 degree angled edge, the user's fingers and or thumb is guided into the correct position, turning manipulating the blade via the hole and ease of use into secondhand nature. Running along cage ceramic bearings, slow rolling the Archie is ultra smooth, as with all We Knives I've handled. You can definitely pull off a thumb flick no problem, but the most addictive and fidgety deploy is the finger flicks that can be done, which are accompanied by the loud solid click of the frame lock. Sporting a 3.5-inch drop point blade comprised from M390 steel with a flat ground stone wash finish, and adding a very generous forward finger choil brings the actual cutting edge down to 3 inches. Located atop of the opening hole is jimping for thumb placement in the open position. As for the maker's mark, it sits adjacent to the steel marking, the Ferrum Forge shield milled into the frame on its lock side. With an overall length of 7 7/8 of an inch, the Archbishop appears to be much bigger in pictures, but in hand, this size feels perfect, and with the choiled areas, the hand comfortably locks into many types of grips. Coming in at only 4.5 ounces and still a little chunky tank of a build, the Bishop is just as impressive in hand as it is on paper. With the design aesthetics, to be honest, it's more impressive in hand. Another great part about the design is it lacks the unwanted double clutch effect that persists on previous models by Ferrum Forge, particularly the Mordax, which I did want before becoming aware of the double clutch situation that also exists on the titanium frame locking Stinger that costs a whopping 550 smackarooskies. So for me and what I was looking for, the Archbishop 2.0 was the obvious and only choice. Although the Archbishop is just about the same size as the Stinger in length, the overbuilt and clearly more robust Bishop, with a blade thickness that's identical to a 160,000 XM18's blade, but with a much better geometry, leaves the Bishop in a less likely position to fold under pressure, no pun intended. In conclusion, the Archie being the most iconic design by Ferrum Forge, owning a part of the history is special. And the original Arch B mid-tech had no jimping on the build, no backspacer, and a pressed spring clip at a price point of about $500. And the 2.0 has addressed these issues, and when released in 2019, had a price point of $275. So it was a deal to say the least. Comment down below with your thoughts on the Archbishop 2.0 and which Ferrum Forge design is your favorite. Also, which would you buy first? Please hit the thumbs up, share, and sub to the channel. With that, I'll be signing off from the Fuller Fanatic.